Under the Trump administration, your government will pay for, or your insurance company will be mandated to pay for, all costs associated with IVF treatment, fertilization for women. As you know, I was always for IVF right from the beginning. As soon as we heard about it, it's fertilization and it's helping women and men and families. I have been a leader on IVF, which is fertilization. The IVF, I have been a leader.
He has been a leader and he definitely knows what it is. He heard about it recently, I guess. It's not new. It didn't come out a year ago, but it's something fertilization. And not only is he a leader, and not only does he know at least what one of the three letters stands for in IVF, he also believes we need to do more, not just to make sure that people have access to it. Dear God, we need to do way more than that. In fact, the government should require your insurance to pay for it. So you get the right, and it's massively expanded over before. Well, now is a great chance to test his ability as a leader of the Republican Party to make the Republicans fall in line. Remember, he did it with the immigration bill. He didn't want them to pass it. He told them, kill it, and they bowed down and did what he said. And so, IVF protection bill that not only protects your access to it, but also forces insurance plans to pay for it. Exactly what he's saying he wants. That leader of IVF goes up for a vote. And the Senate Republicans have blocked it for a second time.
A storm is tearing up the digital media industry. Only our audience can save us in these difficult times. Help us reach our goal of 100,000 new members at tyt.com/team.
I like that the New York Times at least puts into their headline, breaking with Trump, because that is technically true, but also, did they? I mean, I know they broke from what he technically said he wanted, and yet, where is he? I mean, they just stuck a thumb in his eye. He said, you should be able to do this, you should be protected, and it should be paid for. And they were all like, go screw off, Donald Trump. And I guess he's busy. I guess he just doesn't have time to make any phone calls to Senate Republicans. He doesn't have time to tweet about it even. It's just not gonna happen. And in fact, it was almost universally voted down by a suite of dozens of Republicans who swear to God that they support IVF. Only two actually voted in favor of it. That is Senators Lisa Murkowski of Alaska, Susan Collins of Maine, the two that are occasionally, but certainly not always, somewhat reasonable. And so all the rest voted against it. So the Democrats were 9 votes short of the 60 necessary to begin debating it. And I want to do something that used to be very common in the media, but we don't do it anymore because as with so many things, so much has been normalized. It didn't just lose a vote, leaving them 9 votes short of the 60 necessary. It was filibustered. The Republicans did not just not support IVF, the Republican caucus filibustered an IVF protection bill. I know like most people, like if you just started following American politics, you're probably like, what are you talking about? I haven't heard about filibusters in years. Yeah, because we just don't mention it anymore. The assumption is that the minority party will automatically filibuster every piece of legislation. So unless you can get 60 votes, nothing ever happens. And I just wanna make sure that you know that's not how it used to be just a few years ago. The filibuster used to be a tool that was used in only the most extreme circumstances to stop something that was wildly dangerous or wildly unpopular. This bill, not at all dangerous, hella popular amongst Republicans, and yet the Republicans filibustered it. Why is the headline not Republicans filibuster IVF protection bill? And the best we can get is they broke with Trump, I suppose. And so here are some of the reasons why they say they filibustered it, which is what happened. Senator John Cornyn of Texas said the measure is unnecessary because IVF is not currently in jeopardy in most states. Oh, it's not in jeopardy in most states. Well, I guess we shouldn't protect it anywhere then. By the way, they're going full bore ahead to make sure that illegal migrants can't vote, which they already can't, but you don't need to protect IVF because it's only being threatened in a few states. I mean, why should I vote for it? You know what you can do if it's unnecessary? Vote for it and move on with your life. You're not pointing out why it needs to be stopped. You're just implying it's not super necessary, so I guess I can filibuster it. That is, again, not how this stuff used to work in the past. Senator Katie Britt, you remember her, raised concerns that the IVF bill could violate religious freedoms by forcing people who do not believe in the treatments to provide them. No, it can't. It's already in the bill that you will not be forced to do it. It's just that people have the right to access to it. And I love that fictional non-religious infringements on freedom win out over your freedom, over your actual body that exists right now. And that is what Katie Britt had to say. Now, Ted Cruz, who again filibustered the bill, he had a different bill. And he did this the same time before. He doesn't want an all-encompassing bill that actually protects it, nor comes close to actually making your insurance pay for it, like Donald Trump says he wants. Instead, he has a bill that would make states ineligible to receive Medicaid funding if they ban access to IVF. And so he says, I'm an unequivocal supporter of protecting IVF, he said, the week that he filibustered an IVF protection bill. But he said that Democrats are pushing a partisan bill to stoke baseless fears about IVF and push their broader political agenda. You know how the Democrats could successfully stoke fears? If they put a bill like this forward and the Republicans block it, then people will rightly be afraid, because it certainly looks like the Republicans are trying to get ready to strip those rights away. You know how you don't help the Democrats stoke those fears? Just pass it. They put it forward, pass it, move on with your life. And then it's it. It's nullified. It is objectively the case that that would do less fear mongering. And yet 48 of you decided to filibuster it. And by the way, I love that. So he has his alternate bill and he thinks he's being very clever with this. Well, what we're going to do is we're not going to like force people, states to do it. But if they don't do it, they'll lose access to this funding, okay, this Medicaid funding. And so clearly they're not going to risk that. What are you talking about? You know how many red states would love an excuse to just destroy Medicaid in their state and be like, well, we had to because we were fighting for religious freedom. It's funding that goes to the sort of people that they don't care about anyway. He thinks he's being so clever. I see what Ted Cruz is doing. Thanks for watching our video. Did you know that you can support our show by becoming a subscriber? Just click the subscribe button and also ring the bell so that you get notifications when we're live or when we post new content.